cookie at my garage. Should I make it taller?
No, it looks good.
It does?
Gosh, my life now. What can you even say? I have my life back. I don't have to worry about missing something of my daughter's, not being able to go to another family function, not going to work. It's just not even a thought. And I can actually say that that happened the day after surgery.
Well, for 30 years, I've had a really wonderful interior design firm that focuses on historic preservation and restoration, mainly of 18th, 19th, and 20th century structures. My job is very demanding. You have to be on construction sites for many hours at a time. If you didn't know me, you would think that I was doing all the same things and I was exactly the same person. The difference is that I was doing all of that in terrible pain before, and now I wake up every morning and I feel like everybody else must, which is you wake up, you have energy, you're engaged with life, you're engaged with your friends, and you go to work and enjoy it.
Migraine headaches are more common than asthma and diabetes combined. If you think about the number of people in this country who suffer from migraine headaches, it's over 35 million Americans. One in four households has somebody who has a migraine headache or who knows somebody who's affected by it. So I would say migraine headaches are part of all of our lives.
Migraine is a medical condition, so it's not just a headache. It can involve a headache, but it also can involve a number of other symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, dizziness, light sensitivity, sound sensitivity. It can make patients feel terrible both before, during, and after the attack. Sometimes the symptoms can last days long. Sometimes they only last hours. Generally, it's a very disabling condition, especially during the attacks. If you have a number of attacks, it can be very disabling for your life, and it's one of the leading causes of disability in the United States.
Migraines really started to dictate my life and what I was able to do. This wasn't just a few years, it's been 35 years that I was suffering from migraines, and it didn't start until I was about 25. And all of a sudden I noticed the headaches were not normal headaches that other people described. They were searing, life-altering, painful episodes that lasted several days.
I was 24 years old when my migraine started, when I found out I was pregnant with my child. They didn't start out too frequently at first because I didn't know what the triggers were, but then it's just my life moved on and, you know, I was moving forward. They were just coming out of nowhere to the point where I was waking up with them, and they would last anywhere from definitely 3 days to 4 days. The vomiting, the excruciating, I can't handle the light. Many ER visits, and the time I got through another one started.
Because I had young children, you can't exactly say, no, mommy has a headache, I'm not getting up today, but you have to sort of push through it. But it became such a trial to get through every single day, be a good parent, run my business, do interesting activities with my family, and all the while pretending that you felt okay when in fact you were struggling very, very hard.
There was at one point in time I had missed 8 days of work in 1 month, and I didn't know whether today was going to be a good day. If I woke up today without a migraine, okay, I can move on. If not, I missed doctor's appointments, you know, what hair appointments. Just more importantly to me, it was all about my daughter and what I missed from her. And whether it was one program or 10, it didn't matter because she's still my daughter, and I was the one that was supposed to be here for her, and knowing that I couldn't broke my heart all because of these migraines. And it is sad when you have something that bad that's controlling your life. Nobody could find out the problem or nobody could find the fix, and it was just getting so frustrating that I just wanted to give up. And thank goodness I didn't.
I had heard about this surgery from a friend whose daughter suffered from migraines, and he's a doctor, and it was just total luck that he mentioned it to me. The plastic surgeon told me that it was an extensive procedure and that they had discovered it by chance when they realized that several of their patients for whom they were doing other techniques had relief from migraine symptoms, and as they looked into this further, discovered it was a really viable technique to treat migraines directly.
When I try to pick out patients to decide who would be candidates for migraine surgery, I often find more refractory patients who have often failed a number of options, more conservative options, and then I refer to our plastic surgery colleagues At that point, our plastic surgery colleagues will use things such as Dopplers, occipital nerve injections, Botox injections to identify trigger points that may be locations of interest for a migraine decompression surgery. At that point, once the trigger points are found, then our plastic surgery colleagues decide if the patient is going to be a surgery candidate and then proceed to take that patient to surgery once approved.
Migraine headache surgery involves decompression of nerves of the head and neck and was actually designed and discovered by a plastic surgeon. In most patients, you are getting significant improvement. What do I mean by significant improvement? Less migraine headaches to begin with in terms of how many do you get? How bad are they when you get them, like on a scale of 10? How long do they last? And what can you do after surgery that you weren't able to do before surgery? Thankfully, over the last 20 years, we have a substantial amount of science that supports that this works. Most patients are going to get at least a 50% improvement in either how many headaches they have, how bad are they, or how long they last. Most people will get even better than that, 75%, 90%. In some cases, some patients don't have headaches anymore after surgery. Just want to kind of review where you're at since surgery. How many migraine headaches have you had since the last time that I saw you? And again, I want to talk apples to apples. So the same kind of headaches that you were having before surgery, how many of those have you had since the last time I saw you?
Absolutely none.
Well, that makes that a quick visit.
Exactly.
So you have had none since the last time I saw you, and how many?
I never thought in a million years that after all these ER visits, numerous visits to my doctor and neurologist, that I would be referred to a plastic surgeon to take care of my migraines. The plastic surgeon wanted to know where my migraines had stemmed from, and when I explained where they were from the back of the head to the temple, we started out with the Botox injections in the back of the head, and then that lasted over a course of 3 to 4 months. My migraine surgery was a 4-hour and 5-minute surgery. My plastic surgeon had taken 2 nerves out of the back of my head and a nerve out on my temple because he seemed to think that's where the migraine stemmed from, and then I went home that evening.
The plastic surgeon was very precise about the testing that they did in advance of the surgery to ensure that I was a good candidate for it. This included testing various areas with Botox injections and also using ultrasound to determine where the problematic areas were. My migraines were focused on my right side and temporal lobe, so that's what we addressed in the surgery.
What plastic surgeons are doing is helping to create options for these patients who have nowhere else to turn. That's why the important take-home message is that if you're in a situation where you've listened to all of the recommendations and you've tried everything that has been recommended and it hasn't worked for you, then understand that there may be a solution out there in the form of migraine surgery.
I've given many friends this advice. Try everything you can, research everything, go investigate alternate techniques that your neurologist may not be thinking of as a primary focus. Surgery is one of them and very, very viable.
I went from not being able to have a life to having everything I have now back, and I don't have to worry. I've been almost 2 years migraine free, and it's not a doubt in my mind that I am living life like I should have been living it the last 22 years, and I have my plastic surgeon to thank.